Breaking down large concrete structures such as large buildings, skyscrapers, towers, or bridges is not an easy task. Have you ever wondered how these massive structures are demolished? Today, we will dive deep into the world of hydraulic crushers and see how these powerful machines are made and how they work. Hydraulic crushers, as the name suggests, work using hydraulic pumps and valves controlled by a control center. These machines are used to demolish buildings made of concrete and primarily provide an easier way of crushing down walls, pillars, and torsion beams. The engineering that goes into the making of an industrial-sized hydraulic crusher is truly fascinating. Design and engineering. The first and foremost step that goes into the making of a hydraulic crusher is the design of the machine. Engineers carefully assess and determine the scope of work that the hydraulic crusher would be used for, and then make design drafts accordingly. The major factors that are considered while designing the hydraulic crusher include the size of the buildings to be demolished, the type of concrete used, and the performance which is expected from the crusher. To help the engineers, special computerized programs known as the computer aid design software and the finite element analysis tools are used to act as a simulator of the crusher, enabling the engineers to get an idea of the performance and behavior of the hydraulic crusher. One of the most important factors is the crushing force of the crusher. The simulator software helps the engineers program the hydraulic crusher's draw mechanism, the force it would provide, and similar configurations which ensure that the hydraulic crusher would provide desirable results. Material selection. While the design is crucial, the material that goes into the physical making of the machine would determine if the hydraulic crusher can withstand the harsh conditions it would be working in. Therefore, choosing the right metals and alloys is very important. Manufacturers usually opt for hardened steel alloys, since they provide great strength. The steel alloys are used to make the components, which would bear the crushing forces, which are usually the crusher jaws, blades, and the arm of the crusher to which the jaw is attached. Additionally, the main body of the crusher is also made with high-strength steel alloys. The most commonly used steel is known as hardox steel. Hardox is a wear-resistant steel and provides excellent durability even in the most harsh and abrasive conditions. Abrasion-resistant steel is also a common choice for these huge hydraulic crushers, as it is made to withstand massive forceful impacts and does not succumb to wear and tear easily. Moving on, the crusher jaws and blades are the components which come into direct contact with the concrete. Since concrete is a hard material, it can cause abrasion. To prevent the wear and tear, carbide coating, specifically tungsten carbide, is used to provide extreme hardness and preserve the components from breaking down or becoming unstable due to high abrasion. Although preventive measures are taken, some components such as the tips of the crusher jaw are bound to wear down and break. Therefore, keeping in mind the high cost of replacing these whole crusher jaws, engineers apply their strong analytical skills and design such components to be easily replaceable. Hydraulic system and its components. The hydraulic system is basically the powerhouse of the hydraulic crusher. The whole machine is dependent on the power and precision of the hydraulic system. The star components are the hydraulic cylinders that would generate the massive force required to crush concrete. These cylinders are made using high-grade steel alloys. Chrome-plated steel rods are also used within these cylinders to provide resistance to corrosion, rusting, and improve the longevity of the hydraulic system. Special hoses are attached to the hydraulic cylinders to ensure that they are supplied with the correct amount of hydraulic fluid, oil, air pressure, and other necessary elements. These hoses are manufactured specially, keeping in mind the high pressures they must withstand. To increase the integral strength of these hoses, they are often steel braided. The main material that goes into the manufacturing of these hoses is stainless steel, as it guarantees no erosion. However, some manufacturers also use high-grade steel alloys to make these hydraulic hoses. Electrical control unit. The electrical control unit is an important part of the hydraulic crusher, since it provides complete control over the crusher, helping the engineer operate the crusher manually. The control unit is made from high-grade materials such as metals, alloys, plastic, and rubberized finishing is given for waterproofing. The electronic control unit houses all the buttons, programs, and profiles required to operate the hydraulic crusher in different environments, according to the necessary requirement. The operator can choose between different power levels, speeds, and force to adjust the hydraulic crusher's capabilities of crushing and demolishing concrete structures effectively. Nuts, bolts, fasteners, and joints. Each part must be bolted together strongly. Therefore, each nut and bolt are made from alloy steel or stainless steel to secure the hydraulic system, crusher jaws, blades, and all other critical elements fastened together securely. Similarly, any welding that must take place is only done by using the highest quality of steel wires or electrodes. Compromising on even the smallest element can prove to be disastrous for the hydraulic crusher. Molding and casting process. To make each component, manufacturers and engineers work together to design and make molds for the required components such as the crusher jaws or shears, the main body of the hydraulic crusher, and the hydraulic system components. After the molds are prepared, sand in the molten steel is poured into the molds to give shape for each component. This is known as casting. Once the metal in the mold has cooled down, the mold is removed, and the component is carefully extracted. Abrasive blasting. The freshly casted component has a rough surface. To remove any sand, dirt, and smoothen the surface, various abrasive metals such as sand is used. With the help of an air compressor, the abrasive particles are sprayed onto the component with high air pressure, resulting in a smooth surface. Welding and inspection. Once all the components have been casted and cleared, the welding process starts. Each necessary part is welded together using only the highest grade welding wires and materials. This ensures that the weld is structurally strong and can withstand the weight of components without breaking. After the welding, an inspection team carefully checks all components using special 3D inspection equipment to ensure that all parts and components are fit to be used for assembly. If any component is not up to par, it is immediately rejected. Since hydraulic crushers are high-maintenance machines and are extremely costly, any subpar materials used can result in accidents, injuries, and other damages. Therefore, the manufacturers follow a strict quality assurance procedure. Painting. Once the quality control inspectors have passed the components, they are painted according to the requirements and demand. Every part, such as the crusher jaw assembly, the arm, and the main body, is painted. Delicate parts such as the crusher jaw plates and tips are painted using a high-grade rust-proof paint. This ensures that humid weather conditions, rain, or any kind of water would not corrode the component. To further ensure corrosion resistance, some manufacturers may galvanize the steel components. Galvanizing is a process which involves applying zinc layers to the components. Each manufacturer also embossed its logo on the hydraulic crusher, and it is usually painted in a bright color such as white, so it is clearly visible. Similarly, the model number of the hydraulic crusher is also painted. Assembly. When the painting process is complete, all of the finished components are moved towards the assembly point. Engineers carefully select each component and bolt them together using special tools. All the parts of the hydraulic crusher are securely tightened together, and the quality assurance inspectors perform another strict check of every part. After the assembly, the hydraulic crusher is now complete. The assembly team then uses special polishes to give finishing touches to the hydraulic crusher, making it shine for the customer. There you have it. Did you enjoy getting to know the detailed process of how a huge hydraulic crusher is made? Let us know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed today's video, then make sure to leave us a thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to always be updated with the most exciting content as soon as it's uploaded. Thanks for watching. See you again soon in another video.